everybody. This is Taylor Jacobs from Autism Academy. I'm just checking back in on our schedules and routines conversation that we had last week to see how everything's going. For those of you that were able to create a home schedule or routine, awesome. I hope that that's going super well for you. And for those of you that reached out to us and we were able to get you that support, I hope that that is working just as well. Today we're going to talk a little bit about mini schedules. So for those of you that are struggling with your work times with your kids, I know that that's a really big transition because you don't typically do a whole lot of work, like schoolwork, at home. So for those of you that are struggling with that, we're going to talk a little bit about mini schedules and how that can really help you and your kiddos get through that work time. For our older and higher functioning students, their work time can just be laid out by a simple to-do list or a task list. So whatever they need to accomplish for the day that their teachers assign or that they've assigned for the week, you can write out in a task list and say, I need you to complete 1, 2, and 3 before we have lunch, and then I need you to complete 4, 5, and 6 before dinner. That way they have a beginning and an ending time for those activities, and they know exactly what they're supposed to do. For our lower functioning kiddos that really struggle with maintaining engagement and working for a long period of time, we can set up some different mini schedules. Something could be like a first then schedule or a first next then schedule. I'm going to show you really quickly how you could do that in the moment with your student. So first, I am going to do reading. So I'm gonna add a little bit of a visual for my students, okay? I'm gonna write out first I'm gonna do reading, and then I get to play with my blocks, okay? So it could be very simple. You could write it on a piece of paper, a post-it note. You could write it with whiteboard marker on a desk or a table that erases right off. So first we're gonna do reading and then we're gonna play. Okay, for our students that have a little bit more time that they can remain engaged, we could do a first next to them. So first, I'm gonna do math. Next, I'm gonna do reading. And then, I'm going to play on my tablet. Okay? So I have first, I'm gonna do math, next, I'm gonna do reading, and then I'm gonna play, okay? And our mini schedules don't have to be fancy. I drew those out in maybe 10 seconds. So don't make this a time-consuming process. We want this to be effective and work for you because what's happening might change every day. But if you can keep something of a consistent schedule during your work times, that's gonna work really well for your kids and really give them a, this is what I'm starting, this is what I need to complete, and this is when I'm ending. So that they know when that playtime is coming, because when you're at home, they're used to playtime all the time for the most part. And so building that structure of work is gonna take a little bit of time, but giving them some visual support and a schedule is really gonna help. Again, if you have any questions about that, please reach out to your classroom teachers or to me at tjacobs@aaed.org, and we're happy to help you through this process. We're in it together 100%. Have a great day.